Hey, Sneekylinux, back again today. Yep, back again. Another distribution for you to see. This is going to be quite a short one because it's a rather small distro. When I say small, it's really stripped back. This is what OS 10? 10. 10. 10. 10. I remember it was what OS 0, 1, 2, I think. Way back in time. It has incremental improvements, should we say, as we go along. It is Ubuntu-based at the end of the day, so you can't expect too much. But they've just stripped it right back to the bare minimum, really. Really, really all the way back. So I'm just going to show you a few things here once it's installed, which it is here. On the desktop, you get Trash, File Manager, which is PC Man, File Manager, Firefox's web browser, and a new music player, which is called Lollipop. Lollipop. Never heard of it. I've not put any music in it yet. I've just been playing around, really. Yeah. But I don't know why they changed it from the other one. But hey, who am I to say? I'm just here to have Luke. All I'm going to do is open the menu for you and show you a few bits and bobs, because there's not actually much to see, as you will see now. Look. Calculator, password keeper, leaf pad, passwords and keys, screenshot archiver. Just a document viewer and gthumb. For internet, just get FileZilla, transmission and Firefox web browser even. You just get a document viewer under Office. You have to put your own Office suite on, or unless you're going to use, say, online stuff. I suppose that could be an idea. But again, why would you want this one? Okay, because there's lots of others out there at the moment, okay, that do basically the same sort of thing. So I'm thinking, what OS, guys? You're going to have to do something on the next one to make it a bit better. Sound Vision, as we said, Lollipop, MPV Media Player, and Pulse Audio, of course, to control your audio. Under System Tools, with Task Manager, XTerminal, Root File Manager, GW Package Installer, yeah, and your preferences. Drivers, it's all the usual, really. There's nothing new to see. That's why it's like incremental improvements as we go along. It boots fine, really, really quick. Shuts down in about 1 second. Yeah, 1 second, which I thought was rather good. Everything here is ready to play. Under installation, I put all the codecs in straight away because it was easier to do it that way. It was really, really so much easier. If you right-click the desktop and get your desktop preferences, as you can see, it's all the usual. There's nothing too much new. You can do a few more things, but, you know, not much really. Okay, I can change the wallpaper. Not much really is there to be doing there, really. What's this one here? Should it open? No, I don't like that, do you? Oh, no. I should have left that one out. Oh, dearie. Okay, go back to that one now. So much easier. Nice. Now, we used to call it the Lean Green Linux Machine, but there's lots of other distros at the moment that are doing the same sort of thing, e.g. Peppermint. There's lots of other smaller ones that are really light and lean that will do basically the same job, really. I'll open up the browser for you, because I said it's going to be a really quick video, and it is, really. If I go to YouTube, there you go. I'm going straight to the tube. YouTube. See, it runs rather nice. It's all right, isn't it? It's super duper. I mean, what more can you say, really? It does what it's supposed to do. But on the other hand, as I said before, there is lots that will do the same for you. Video playback is fine. I'll just put me in so you can see one of mine, just to say how it plays back. There's the one I've done the other night. It was Linux Lite. Oh, we get adverts. What do I want adverts? I don't want adverts. No. A couple of comments already. Blimey. I'll skip that ad. And there's a video I did, okay? And a 480. We can go right up to 1080-60, shall we? Will it play it? Let's see. There's no reason why it shouldn't. Yeah, looks alright, doesn't it? Looks good. Do it full screen. Yeah, full screen. Comes up okay. So it'll do all you want it to do, really, at the end of the day. But, you know, is there anything different about it? Unfortunately, no. It's still a rather good distro, if you want to say really small, because it'll fit on a CD, no problem. But it is so stripped back, there is nothing else I can show you about it, really. Yes, you can configure the themes and the icons and stuff like that. If we go back down here, I'll show you what I mean. Where are we? Under preferences. Customize look and feel you can do, yeah. Desktop setting sessions, you know. There's just nothing here to say, yeah, I'm going to put that in. No, I'm going to use that this time around. Bear in mind, it's been going quite a few years. So guys at WhatOS, give me something different, still lean and green, and a Linux machine, but not continue the same, okay? We've all got to move on, whether we like it or not, but I think you need to do something different next time. Okay, it's rather nice though. Sneaky Linux out. I'll see you later. Bye bye.